Hi everyone. We are live for our class tonight. Real quick, I am going to be using just some regular washcloths, and I'm going to be using it on this slippery floor. So something that is, you know, you can glide around on. If you don't have something to glide around with, sliders or a dish rag, maybe use some magazines on a carpet area. So that, and some hand weights. Nothing crazy, I just have threes. So grab those real quick. So you have a mat, you have a floor where you can use some glider work, and you have some hand weights. So grab those few things, and we'll get started in just a minute. Alright, so if you're just joining us, we are using gliders or dish rags on a slippery floor and some light hand weights. These aren't even a requirement, so you can just use regular arm strength without hand weights if you don't have. So just another minute. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and get started. So I'm just gonna start my workout on my watch. All right, so I have my hand weights. I just have threes, and I'm gonna come standing, just like regular standing work, just to warm up our body. So, or just like as if we were on the reformer, that's what I meant to say. So feet, our hip distance apart. Let's flip those palms to face in front of you. So press down through your feet, really ground yourself, hip distance apart. From here, we're just gonna lift up onto our tiptoes, slowly lower. So warming up those ankles and calves. Once you're ready, add in some bicep curls. If you don't have hand weights, that's okay. Maybe just move your arms. So lift and lower. Breathing, checking in with your body. So that Pilates breath, it's an inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Starting to sync that breath with your movement. All right, now let's go for that first position. So heels glued together, down at the floor, we're still rooted through our feet. Toes about 5 inches apart. So same thing with the arms. Same thing, lift and lower. So your heels might come apart as you lift. Just squeeze them together at the bottom. Squeeze through those biceps. Maybe you're creaking and stuff like my ankle just was. Lifting, lowering. Three, two, and one. All right, let's take a wide second position. So toes face out, heels face in. And let's hug that big beach ball or that big tree in front of our chest. So sink down. And from here, we're just gonna stand up. When you're ready, add in the arms. So sink low, open those arms out. Exhale, squeeze through the glutes, lift up. Squeeze those chest muscles as those weights come together. So palms face each other, keeping a micro bend in that elbow. Make sure those shoulders are relaxed. So shoulders are down your back. You're finding that breath. Inhale and exhale. So those inner thighs are active. Squeeze through those inner thighs as you lift. Three, distance apart, parallel. So root down 3 feet, arms go out in front of you, palms face each other, sink down for a squat. So this time booty goes behind you. As you come up here, squeeze through your glutes, press those arms straight back behind you. So sink down, arms go straight out, just about shoulder height. Make sure shoulders aren't crunched up. As you come up, squeeze through the glutes, press through the heels, press those arms back. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. You want to add on, maybe that right leg sweeps out. As you come up, switch for the left on the next side. Out to this side, straight leg. Two more on each side. Two. Two. One. One. All right. So from here, let's, I'll turn to the side so you can see me. I'm going to keep my feet parallel. I'm just gonna step my right foot back so that my toe's still touching the ground. Palms are facing each other. Hand weight's still there. Little micro bend in that left knee. Roll out the shoulders. They're down your back. You're just gonna hinge here. Coming as parallel to the floor as you can. Come right back up. Tap the toes. Right back into it. So don't let those shoulders round through your collarbone. Press those shoulders down the back. Open the collarbone. That was three. Balance challenge. Last three. Last two. Last one. Try to make it your best. Get parallel to that floor. Slowly come up. All right. Other leg. So, step that left foot back. Toe touches to start. Roll out your shoulders. Hinge forward. Trying to get parallel to the floor. Slowly come up. Micro bend in that standing leg. Hinge. Slowly come up. Maybe concentrate on something stationary. The crown of your head is growing tall, even though you're hinged forward. Grows tall. Grows tall to that wall right in front of you, or whatever it might be. Last two. Last one. Slowly come up. All right. So set one of those hand weights down. Keep one of them. Or maybe set them both down. Whatever you're feeling today. Feet are planted on your mat. About hip distance apart or closer. Maybe they're squeezing together. Your choice. So grab each end of your hand weight. Come rolling down. Arms straight up. Palms face each other. Feet are planted. Take a deep inhale. On your exhale, roll all the way up, articulating through that spine. Sit up tall at the top. And again. So curl under, one vertebra at a time. So low back touches first. Slowly, with resistance, lower down. Exhale through the mouth, tuck the chin to the chest. Roll through that spine. Sit up nice and tall. So a few more roll-ups here. The weight's bugging you to sit down. Maybe you lift your arms overhead now. Bring your biceps by your ears. Last one. All right, bring one leg at a time to a tabletop. So from here, you have a 90 degree angle at your knee joint. Press that belly button into your spine, pressing that spine into the mat by using those abs. So imagine those low abs are pressing that low back to your mat. Dumbbell is still in your hand. Rest your head, take a deep inhale on your exhale. Roll up, get those shoulder blades off the mat. Inhale, lower down. Exhale, reach to those shins, lower down. If the hand weight's bugging you, just use those hands. They reach and lower. Exhale through the mouth, reach, lower. Keep pressing that spine into the mat by using those abs. Three. Exhale, two. Last one, hold it up there. Hug that right leg in, left leg goes straight out. So I'm hugging right under my knee and on the outside of my ankle. Slow switch. Hug the opposite leg in, point through the toes, and switch. Use that breath. Single leg stretch. Try to curl up even higher. One, hug those knees in, keep those shoulder blades lifted. Now, both of your legs are gonna extend out, so squeeze those inner thighs together, circle those arms around, hug those knees in, lift up. Inhale, reach, find some length. Exhale, hug it in, reach. And one, hug it in. All right, legs to the tabletop. Fingertips to the nape of your neck. Twist to the left, twist to the right. Use that breath. Keep those shoulder blades lifted as much as you can. If you want to add on, opposite leg reaches straight out. Take it slow. Think opposite rib touches the top of the hip. So left rib to right hip, vice versa. Three, two, and one. Rest it down. Hug those knees in. So rock up to sitting. Plant those feet. Let's do about hip distance apart again. Your palms are gonna come onto the mat. All 10 fingers facing your feet. So from here, I'm just gonna lift up. So I'm in like a tabletop reverse plank. So from here, we're just gonna get a tiny bit of triceps in. So elbows point straight back. And then arms straighten. So, a little bit of tricep dips here. Arms are my weakness. Need all the arms we can get. I do, at least. Four, three, two, one. Walk those feet out. Arms are still up there. So now you're in that reverse plank. So from here, I'm actually gonna really root in through my heels. I'm gonna try to glide my bottom back behind me without touching the mat, and then lift it right back up. So straighten the legs as you send that booty behind you. Try not to let it hit the mat, and then pull through your heels. Bring it forward. So just like that tendon stretch on the reformer that's so hard to do. Great, you guys, keep with it. Three, guys. So today we're gonna focus a lot on lower body. We did a lot of arms last week. So we're gonna do lower body. And we're gonna get a little bit of cardio in. So come standing. So feet are hip distance apart, parallel. Let's start with our right foot forward. So right foot forward, step that left foot back so that you can go into a nice lunge. So hips are facing forward, abs are pulled in, so bottom ribs don't flare open. Top of the head, crown of the head is nice and tall. So sink low into your lunge. Find where you need to be on your mat and then lift up. Beautiful. So we have 30 seconds like that. I'm starting the clock now. So lunge and lift. So try to balance while talking. We're focusing on this right seat area. If it's hard for you to connect there, maybe you need a little bit of a hinge forward, but keep that collarbone wide even if you're hinging forward. So no slouching in those shoulders. And don't let that belly rest on that thigh. All right, so 30 seconds is up. Now we have 30 seconds of stepping that left foot up and then stepping it back, staying low. Step up, step back. Maybe get those arms going. Get that heart rate up a tiny bit. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Step it up. Good job. All right, so now opposite leg steps back. So left foot is forward, right foot steps back. Find your nice, strong position. So make sure this right hip is facing forward. Don't let it open out to the side. And 30 seconds, timer starts now. So sink low, lift up. It doesn't have to be a huge movement. Strong through that left glute. That knee, that front knee, doesn't go past your toes. So it goes just to midfoot. Four, three, two, one. Now that leg steps up and back. Stay low. Keep breathing. Find your balance. Stay steady in that knee. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Step it up. All right. So now we're just gonna do a little curtsy variation. So let's start on the left side of our mat. So both feet, they're about hip distance apart again, parallel. Left foot goes behind for a curtsy lunge and then step it up. So starting the timer right now, curtsy and up. So it's your range of motion. As long as this knee is staying strong, it's not going past those toes. Keep breathing. Really powering up through the seat area. All right, our 30 seconds is up. Now we're gonna stay low in that lunge. We're just gonna hop that leg back. Regular lunge, hop into curtsy lunge. So trying to stay low. Keep going, you guys. Keep breathing. Six, five, four, one. Good work, you guys. So we have the other side, unfortunately. So both feet to the right corner. Hip distance apart with those feet. This time, our right leg steps back. Step it forward. Timer is starting. So check in with your knee. Knee is strong. It's not bending past those toes. Core is tight. One, now we have those hops. So regular lunge, back to curtsy lunge. Hop, hop. You come out of it, come right back in. Don't worry about time, I got you guys. One, step it up. All right, let's take a little breather. So we're gonna stretch both sides, so it doesn't matter which side you start on. So I'm gonna take my left ankle crosses over my right knee, maybe sink down into it, press that booty behind you, stretch that glute area. Maybe you need to hold onto a wall to really enjoy this stretch. I'm warm, I don't know about you guys. All right, switch sides. All right, so now the super fun part. Grab one of your gliders or your rag, or if you don't have a slippery floor or glossy floor to do this on, grab a magazine and do it right on your carpet. So I'm just going to put this down right in front of me. I'm going to start with my right foot or the top of my foot on that rag. So from here, that foot with the rag, hands can just be on your hips, feet parallel, hip distance, chest is open, shoulders down your back. Abs are pulled in, crown of the head is tall. Just checking in. All right, so from here, sink back for a reverse lunge. Bring those hands to frame that left foot. Then that left foot goes back over the right ankle from here, just like as if we were on a reformer. We pipe those hips up, gaze at the thighs, press those feet back, regular plank, step that left foot forward. From here, lift your belly off of your thigh. Use those glutes to come up. So try to put more focus in your glutes rather than making it all quad dominant. So we have 9 more on that side. Here we go. All right. Reverse lunge. Frame the foot. Cross the ankle over. Pike up. Pike back. Step it up. Pull those abs in. Lift from the glutes. Beautiful. 8. If you want to add on, maybe you do a push-up while you're in your plank position. I'm going to leave that out today, but that's up to you. 7. 6. Really spread your fingertips nice and wide. Distribute that weight in your hand. That was a nice stomp. All right, use those glutes to come up. Last 5, halfway on this side. Pike up, pike back, step it up, glide it forward. 4. 3. Last 2. Last 1. other side. Let's get right into it. Lunge back, frame the foot, cross it over, pike up. Drop your gaze as your hips lift up so that your neck stays in line with your spine. Eight more. Seven. One. All right, are you guys warm? I know I'm sweating. Okay, so now let's keep that heart rate up. We're gonna do three rounds of two moves each. So our first move is gonna be, first of all, grab your other rag or glider, so you have two. We're gonna do 20 jump squats. So, just like how we warmed up, feet hip distance apart, rooted down through those heels, sink low, arms go straight out in front of you, or chest center. As you jump, swing them back. One, two, three. I'll stop counting out loud, you guys go at your own pace. Really send that booty back behind you. Press through those heels. Three, two, one. All right. Take a little breather. Grab a sip of water if you need it. So normally at this time, it would be our 20-20-20 class. We always make sure we get in that cardio, so we're keeping with habit. All right, so our next move, we have both of our gliders. And you can always do this on your mat if you prefer not to use the gliders. We just have 20 mountain climbers. So full plank position, right knee in, left knee in. That was two. And 20. All right, two more rounds. So, starting with those jump squats. When you're ready, 20 on your own count. I'm just gonna go turn the thermostat down. Okay, not sure why I didn't do that to start. So I'm gonna meet you guys at 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Just like we're on the reformer, right? 2, 1. Take a little breather, and we'll come right back into those mountain climbers. Okay, when you guys are ready, if you'd rather just count to 20 seconds, that works. Otherwise, 20 knee pull-ins. So fingertips spread wide, distribute that weight through your palm, crown of the head growing tall, just like you're in a plank. And 20. promise you guys, I don't like feeling like I'm talking myself. All right, here we go. 20 jump squats, feet hip distance apart. Really root through those heels. Relax the shoulders. You guys got this.
Beautiful. I've been having a little bit of hip issues in this hip, so I need this.
carrying around that little toddler. I always have some sort of little injury going on of lately. And now reverse it. So sweep down, kick the leg up. Ooh, that was messy. So take your time if your core is not stable like mine. Take your time to stabilize. Turn out in that foot. Three, two, and one. All right, now we bring those feet to that front corner. So from here, lift that top leg to hip height. And from here, let's just draw behind us. Open up to that hip, sweep forward. Point behind you, flex in front of you. Point and flex. Core is stable. All right, and now we have one more adjustment. Those legs, I lied, we have two more. So those hips stay at the back edge of the mat. Those feet come straight out from the hip like an L shape. Flex both feet, lift that top leg up and lower. Lift, just a hip height, slowly resist the down. So this would be, this whole sideline series would be great. You have maybe some ankle weights. I have some somewhere buried in my closet. You get those out. Two. Last one, keep it lifted. We're gonna touch those toes down to our bottom toes. Arch up like a rainbow, heel to heel. So arch toes to toes. Try to get that nice arch, heel to heel. Internal rotation, external rotation. Comes from the hip socket. You're not just moving your ankle or moving from the knee. You're coming right from that hip socket. So thigh bone faces down, thigh bone faces up. Two, two, one, one. Now bend those knees, 90 degree at the knee joint. Keep those heels glued together, toes apart as you lift up to that clamshell. Slowly lower, lift, control the lower. Now lift that leg without keeping the heels glued and lower. Keep that 90 degree angle at the knee joint. Keep those bottom obliques pulled up and in. Don't forget about them. Or you always could add on here by grabbing your dumbbell and maybe just holding it on your thigh. I'm not up for the overachieving at the moment, but if you guys want to grab that, go right ahead. All right, now lift, draw those big circles, keeping that knee bent. Lot of side glute work. And then reverse. Keep breathing, where's your breath? Find it if you've lost it. It's sync to your movement. All right, last thing, lift that top leg up, hip height. Stretch that leg straight out, flex the foot, bend it, point it straight out. I'm sorry, lengthen the leg straight out, flex the foot, bend, two, and one. Nice work. So come up like you're gonna sit cross, crisscross, and bring that side we just worked right out to the opposite thigh. Maybe hug it in, maybe you need to hinge forward. Root down here through that hip, through those sitting bones. Feel this stretch. All right, other side. So hips to the back edge. Remember to, if you use your dumbbell on the other side, you can use it on this side too. So hips are behind me. Legs are straight out from the hip. From here, you're just gonna lift that top leg hip height. You're gonna sweep it forward and press it back behind you. So Find some length in that hip. Flex forward, point and reach. Bottom oblique is active, so there should be that little tiny mouth hole. You're not just flopped down onto that mat. Core is always active. Relax your neck and jaw, relax your shoulders. Squeeze through the glute, find that length through the hip. Last one. All right, so from here, keep that top leg lifted, plant that bottom hand, or that top hand to stabilize, lift inner thigh, inhale, lower, exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. Stable through that core. Those obliques are working. Three, two, one. Rest it down. Développé. So turn out in the foot, that top foot. Draw that toe up the knee. Straighten the leg. Resist it down. Sweep up. Straighten. Lower. Struggling with these ones today. Tight hips. Two. One. All right, reverse it. Strong through the glute, long through the hip, strong through that middle. So don't let that top hip roll out to the ceiling. Keep it shining forward. If you need that extra stability, plant that top hand. All right. So stack onto the bottom foot, lift up, draw those circles. So coming from the glute and press back so that that thigh is just behind the hip so that you're finding that length again. And reverse. Remember, the glute's working, the glute's the motor. The leg is just the tire. All right, lower down. Walk those feet into that L shape now. So ankles are in line with those hips like the letter L. Flex both feet, lift that top leg, lower. Lift and lower. Resist down, don't just let it flop down. Stay active through those obliques. Last one, keep it lifted, draw those rainbows, so toes to toes, internal rotation, arch it up, heel to heel, external rotation. So remember, it's coming from that hip joint, you're not just moving the ankle or the knee. Find that arch, struggling on this side too. Arch, heel to heel, arch, toe to toe. Two, two. One, up, one. Bend the knees, 90 degree angle at the knee joints. Hips are behind you, slightly behind the shoulders. Heels stay glued together. Lift that top leg for clamshell. Inhale, lower, lift, lower. So toes come apart, heels stay glued. If you want that dumbbell, just hold it onto that thigh, let it rest there. Just steady it with your hands, add some weight. Now, lift the heel with the leg. So heels come apart, lift and lower. Keep the control on the down. Getting shaky, I don't know about you guys. Missing the studio right about now. Alright, keep it lifted. Draw those circles. Those big knee circles. Hips not rocking and rolling. Everything's sturdy above the waist. And reverse. Alright. Come up like you were to sit cross, crisscross. That side we just worked though. Cross it over the other side. Maybe a little hinge forward. Try to press that right sitting bone down. Breathe. Most importantly, relax the shoulder, relax the jaw, relax the neck. Alright, let's lie onto our tummy. Let's get that extension work. So, right here, immediately let's find some length in our low back. Hands come right under our armpits. Spread the fingertips nice and wide. Rest the tops of the feet. I'm gonna rest my head down. On the exhale, straighten those arms just to your point of control. And inhale, lower. So your arms might go all the way straight. They might not, mine don't. As long as you are not dumping into that low back, you're staying long in that spine. All right, let's stack hands, one on top of the other. Glue the forehead to the top hand. Take a deep inhale on your exhale, lift up. From here, you're gonna open out that left arm, look to the left, come back center. I'm sorry, that was the right. But we're gonna do both sides. Open up the left, look left, come back. Back to right, to left, two, stay long through the crown of the head, two. And one, rest it down. Last set of extension work. Hands are still stacked. Take that deep inhale. Exhale, lift up. Maybe lift those thighs up if you can keep the length of your low spine. If you're jumping into your back, rest them back down. So it might just be a half of an inch or less off the mat. From here, lower an inch, lift an inch with that chest and arms. Keep breathing. Crown of the head is long. Check in with your body. All right, just checking on you guys. Three, two, one, rest it down, press up, sit back for a child's pose. Soaked, heels apart, toes together, knees wide, press that forehead down, reach long. Let's get some cat-cow stretches. Inhale, arch the spine, tuck the tailgate at the navel. Exhale, reverse. Move with your breath. Maybe you need to shake out your hips here. All right, curl the toes under. Lift the hips, down dog. Baby, pedal it out. All right, walk your feet into your hands. Straight legs as far as you can. And then micro bend in your knees if you need it to get those palms flat on the mat in front of you. So really feel this release through the spine. So relax the head, neck, and jaw. Shake the head no. Nod the head yes. Slowly peel up one vertebra at a time. Roll out your shoulders. All right, you guys made it. Miss you guys so much. And don't forget to drink a lot of water. Get some sunlight. So Obviously our lungs need oxygen, so do our pores, so do our skin. So try to get some fresh air. All right, miss you guys. See you soon.